Good morning, students. Okay, in continuation of yesterday video, we see conformational isomerism. What is conformational isomerism? Okay, the isomers which are produced by the rotation of carbon-carbon single bond are called conformational isomers, conformers. And the phenomenon is called as conformational isomerism. The conformational isomerism mainly exhibited by alkanes. Okay, here cycloalkanes. Alkanes and cycloalkanes. That means derivative of alkanes. Only carbon-carbon single bond molecule exhibit here this conformational isomerism. Okay, here. Okay, conformational isomerism of any molecule easily explained by using Newman production formula. Newman production formula. Yesterday we saw Newman production formula. What is Newman production formula? Okay. How we write the Newman production formula of ethane, butane, propane and other molecules. Okay, based on the Newman production formula, just I'll explain. I have to explain the conformational isomerism of different alkanes. First, we will see the conformational isomerism of ethane. The molecular formula of ethane is C2H6. The condenser structure of ethane is CH3CH3. This is the condenser structure. Condenser structure of ethane is CH3CH3. Molecular formula of ethane is C2H6. Okay. Next. Okay, here write the Fischer structure. Why we write the Fischer structure here? We will write Newman production formula, Newman structure by using Fischer structure. By using the Fischer structure. How will you write the Fischer structure? First, you take the one vertical line. You take one vertical line. After that, based on the number of carbon atoms, you draw the horizontal lines on the vertical line. On the vertical line. Okay, here how many carbons are there? 1, 2, 2 carbons are there. So, you draw the 2 horizontal lines on the vertical line. Okay, the meeting point of vertical line and horizontal line, the meeting point of vertical line and horizontal line, we call as carbon. We consider as carbon. Okay, here how many hydrogens are there? 3. Here, hydrogen. Here, hydrogen. Here, hydrogen. And the separation should be 120 degrees. This separation should be maintained 120 degrees. Okay. And here H, here also H, here also H. This is the Fischer structure of ethane. Fischer structure of ethane. Then, see the molecule from this way. Carbon we call front carbon. This carbon we call back carbon. Okay, then by writing Newman projection formula, okay, we consider only two carbon atoms. What are those? One is front carbon and back carbon. Okay, here in Newman projection, front carbon indicate with dot. Okay, back carbon indicate with circle. Front carbon indicate with dot. Back carbon indicate with circle. Okay. Next, here also arrange the groups, arrange the all the substances or atoms are present in ethane molecule with the 120 degrees separation. With the 120 degrees separation. So, here front carbon, up here front carbon, downside one hydrogen, here this side one hydrogen, this side one hydrogen, and front car pullover. Then move to back car. Here hydrogen, here hydrogen, here hydrogen. This is the Newman structure of ethane. Newman structure of ethane. This ethane we call as staggered ethane. This ethane we call as staggered ethane. Okay, if we rotate this molecule, why we call carbon-carbon single bond rotation? This is the front carbon, back carbon. Front carbon, back carbon has a single bond. Rotate a single bond. Okay, just rotate the single bond. Rotate the single bond in different way, and then we'll get one more isomer here that we called. Okay, that we called conformer of this one, conformational isomer of this staggered ethane. This called staggered ethane. Rotate. This is the symbol for rotation. This is the symbol for rotation. Rotate 60 degrees here. 60 degrees. What happened? Okay, rotate only one carbon. Front either back. Okay, here I am rotating back carbon. Here I am rotating back carbon. What happens here? Rotate back carbon 60 degrees. Front as this. Here I am rotating front as this. There is no change in front carbon. Rotate bar back carbon 60 degrees. 60 separation is 120. These two separation is 120. 60 means this hydrogen comes here. This hydrogen comes here. This hydrogen comes to. Okay, near to that front carbon of hydrogen, front carbon hydrogen. That means here hydrogen, here hydrogen, here hydrogen. After the rotation of 60 degrees back carbon, we get this structure. This structure is called eclipsed ethane. This structure we call eclipsed ethane. And here, which is more stable? Which is more stable? We'll see in conclusion. And these two, staggered ethane and eclipsed ethane, both are the conformational isomers of ethane. Okay, conformational isomers of ethane. These two are produced by the rotation of carbon-carbon single bond. Carbon-carbon single bond. These two are called conformers of ethane. And which is more stable here? Okay, here all the hydrogen atoms are maintained in symmetrical way, and all the hydrogen atoms are arranged in a symmetrical manner, and one hydrogen far away from another hydrogen. Okay, so this is the most stable, and here also symmetrically arranged, but one hydrogen near to another hydrogen, front carbon hydrogen near to back carbon hydrogen. So we have the eclipsed repulsive forces between two hydrogen atoms. Such forces we call eclipsed forces. Due to those repulsive forces, the stability of eclipsed ethane is less than the staggered ethane. This is less stable. Why? Because repulsive forces present between two hydrogen atoms. And here the energy, sometimes they may ask question, what is the energy difference between these two? 12.5 kilojoules per kilocalories per mole. The energy difference between these two, staggered ethane and eclipsed ethane, is nearly 12.5 kilojoules per mole. 12.5 kilojoules per mole. This is about the conformational isomerism of ethane. Conformational isomerism of ethane. How many conformational isomers are possible for the ethane? Two conformational isomers are possible for the ethane. What are those? One is staggered ethane and second one is eclipsed ethane. Which is more stable? Staggered ethane is more stable. Why? All hydrogen atoms are far away from each other, and here eclipsed ethane, all hydrogens are
two hydrogens each other near to each other and have repulsive forces. Such repulsive forces we called as eclipsed forces. Due to eclipsed forces, eclipsed ethane is less stable than and staggered ethane. Okay, that energy difference between these two is 12.5 kilojoules per mole. This is about the conformational isomerism of ethane. Then in continuation, we will see the conformational isomerism of
propane. Okay, what is the structure of, what is the formula of propane? C3H8. Formula CH3, CH2, CH3. This is the formula, this is the condensed structure. Okay, here, write first Fischer structure. Okay, what is the Fischer structure? First, write vertical line. How many carbon atoms are there? 3 carbon atoms. Hydrogen. Here, hydrogen. This is the Fischer structure of ethane. Okay, see the molecule from this way. We consider only 2 carbon atoms. This is the front carbon. This is the back carbon. We consider only 2. Okay, Newman projection formula has only 2 carbon atoms. Here I am writing Newman projection formula. Okay, here what? Front carbon. Here back carbon. Okay, we consider only this is the front carbon. Here hydrogen. Here hydrogen. Here hydrogen. Finished front carbon. Back carbon. This consider as complete one group, methyl group. Cap side methyl group, this side hydrogen, and this side hydrogen. This we call staggered propane. Okay. Next. Rotate this one 60 degrees. Only back carbon. Either front carbon. But here I am rotating back carbon 60 degrees. Okay. What happens? Front carbon as usual. Here hydrogen. Here hydrogen. Here hydrogen. Okay. It will come near to this one. It will come near to. Hydrogen come near to this one. Hydrogen come to near to this one. Same as this, this we call eclipse propane. This we call eclipse propane. All eclipse structures are unstable due to the repulsive forces between them. So this is unstable. This is more stable. The energy difference between these two nearly 14 kilo calories are joules. 14 kilo calories per mole. Or kilo joules per mole. This is the energy difference between these two structures. This is about the conformational isomerism of propane. Then in continuation we will see the last compound in this series of alkanes. Conformational isomerism of butane. What is the formula of butane? C4H10. The formula of butane is C4H10. Okay, condensed structure is CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. Here we consider middle two carbon atoms. One is front carbon and another one is back carbon. Symmetrical also. We consider also in symmetrical way. Okay, based on this, write Fischer structure. How many carbon atoms? We consider only 2 carbon atoms. First, draw write only to characterize one, nothing will happen, but write to here CH3, here H, here H, here H, here H, here H, CH3. Okay now, see the molecule from this way. See the molecule in this way. What happened? Okay, right here is the Fischer structure. Right here, Neumann structure. Neumann structure first. How will write the Neumann structure? Okay, front carbon, back carbon. Like this. Front carbon, downside CH3, hydrogen, hydrogen. Back carbon, this is the front carbon. This is back carbon. Front carbon and back carbon. Okay, upside. CH, this side H, this side H. See, all the groups are far away from each other. This we call staggered. Staggered butane. And here two methyl groups are opposite to each other. Opposite to each other. So we call anti-staggered. We call anti-staggered. This is the first structure. That is the first structure.
That is the first structure of butane. First structure of butane.
Okay. Next. Rotate this one 60 degrees. Rotate only back carbon. Rotate only back carbon. Okay, 60 degrees. What happened? Back carbon. Methyl comes here, hydrogen comes here, hydrogen comes here. See, first there is no change in that front carbon. Okay, I wrote asterisk. Okay, front carbon. Then in continuation, we rotate now. Okay, we rotate here. CH3 comes here. Okay, here. H comes here, H comes here. Okay, this molecule is eclipsed butane. Eclipsed butane. This is the second structure. And here not completely eclipsed, only hydrogen, hydrogen, only one hydrogen, hydrogen repulsive force are there. So we call it partially eclipsed. This we call partially eclipsed butane. Again, rotate this one 60 degrees. Again, rotate this one 60 degrees. Okay, back carbon only. What happens? Why I am rotating here again? After rotation also, we get same molecule. That's why I didn't rotate here. Okay, here. After rotation of this one, we didn't get this one. So, I am rotating in continuation way. Okay, rotate 60 degrees, back carbon only. What happens here? CH3 ISTs, this CH, here H. Okay, hydrogen comes here. This CH3 comes here. Hydrogen comes here. Here, these two are the bulky groups. These two are the alky groups. This is also one of the staggered. But due to these bulky groups, repulsive forces, which we called repulsive forces between two bulky groups, we called as steel hindrance. Steel hindrance. Due to this steel hindrance, this structure has less stable than first structure. Due to steel hindrance, okay, the third structure less stable than first structure, anti-staggered. Both are staggered. This is also staggered. Okay, staggered. But here, due to the repulsive forces, this is less stable. And here, one more thing, this we call normal staggered. Another name of this one is Gaussian. structure, skew structure and Gaussian structure. So we get here Gaussian structure. Next step, rotation of 60 degrees. Again this one. We will get one more molecule, CH3, here CH3, here H, here H, here H, here H. This is the force structure. See, hydrogen-hydrogen eclipse, here hydrogen-hydrogen eclipse, here methyl-methyl eclipse. Here hydrogen-hydrogen only one eclipse, so we call it partial eclipse. Here completely eclipse, na, we call it fully eclipse. Fully eclipsed in butane is the force structure. And here, here we have steric hindrance, and here eclipsed forces, eclipsed repulsive forces. Here only steric hindrance. Okay, here only eclipsed attraction, eclipsed repulsive forces. Eclipsed repulsive forces. Here no forces. No forces are in first structure. Okay, doesn't exhibit any type of forces.
It doesn't exhibit any type of forces. So,
first is the more stable. Here I am writing stability. First molecule is more stable. So, which one? Anti-Stoddard is more stable. After that, again one more stable. Which one? Third structure. What is this? Gaussian. Why? First is more stable, no repulsive forces, no any type of repulsive forces, no any type of steric hindrance. That's why anti-Stoddard is more stable. More stable. The energy difference between these three is 17.2 kilojoules per mole. Okay, little bit change also is also in different books. 17.2 kilojoules per mole. And here, after the Gaussian, why Gaussian is unstable here? Due to the steric hindrance between two methyl groups. Okay, then eclipse, you take eclipse, both eclipse are there. One is partial is there and another is fully eclipse. Partial eclipse contain only one type of repulsive forces, that is eclipsed repulsive forces. So, second is more stable than fourth. Third is more stable than second, is partially eclipse. The energy difference between is nearly 16.1 kilojoules or kilocalories per mole. Energy increasing means stability decreases here. Okay, next, finally, fourth one, what is that? Fully eclipse. Why fully eclipse is unstable? It has eclipse attraction forces along with the steric hindrance. Due to these,
repulsive and steric hindrance, stability will explain like this. Stability explained like this. This is about the conformational isomerism of ethane, butane, and propane. In continuation, we will see the conformational isomerism of
tartaric acid. This time you only need the structure and rotation. What is the structure of tartaric acid? COOH. CH OH CH OH CO OH. This is the structure of tartaric acid. Here also consider middle two carbon atoms and write the first. Okay, Fischer structure means easy. Here COOH, here OH, here H, here OH, here H, here COOH. Okay, here see the molecule in by this way. Okay, next write the number. This is the Fischer structure. Okay, write the Neumann structure. Neumann structure here dot circle, arrange the groups like this. This is the front carbon. This is back carbon. What happens here? See. Okay, front carbon this one now. Dot here OH, here H, here COOH, here COOH, this side OH and H. This is the first Neumann structure of tartaric acid, first structure. Okay, all our COOH groups are opposite now. Opposite means this we call stronger. Okay, it is more stable. So called anti-stronger. Rotate this 160 degrees. Only back part. What we get? Front carbon has this. OH here. OH here. COOH. Here OH. Okay, here COOH. And here H. H. This is eclipsed structure. This is eclipsed structure. Eclipsed tartaric acid. This is unstable. Second structure. We will see continuation stability. Again rotate this also 60 degrees. Only back part. OH, H, COOH. Here, COOH. Here, sorry. OH, here, H. See, it is also staggered. Staggered, this is the dot structure. Okay, then rotate this one 60 degrees. We get one more structure. COOH. COOH comes near. Here H comes to near OH. And here OH. And here H. This is also eclipse. See. This is the fourth structure. Okay, continuation will get up. Some more structures. Okay, rotation of this one. 60 degrees. What will be it? Front carbon has this. H, C, O, H. OH comes here. Okay. OH comes here. Then here. OH na? H, C, O, H. Has the same like this one. Okay. Fifth structure I'll go. Fourth structure here is same. Fifth structure and the third structure same. This is also one type of tartar. By rotating, we get so many structures. All these are the conformational isomers of conformational isomers of tartaric acid. This is Vicon Gaucher 1. This is Gaucher 2. See here, which is more stable? All tartars are more stable. All staggered are more stable. This is antina, so it is more stable first. Then second one, this one. Here bulky,
here bulky group ko repulsive forces are there, and here hydrogen bonding is present in between two OH molecules. Here there is only bulky groups, so third is more stable. Then fifth, then this one. Why this one? Only eclipsed are there. Here eclipsed along the steric anions. Bulky groups are there. Nothing is which both are bulky groups. Eclipsed and here steric anions. So fourth is unstable. This is the stability order. Stability order. Order of various conformational isomers of tartaric acid. Various conformational isomers of tartaric acid. This is about the conformational isomerism of tartaric acid and alkenes. Okay, next video we'll see conformational isomerism of cycloalkanes. Cycloalkanes. We'll see after that. We'll move into one more topic. Thank you.